you don't fear the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall.
Hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay.
Hope that you fall in love, it hurts so bad. The only way you can know is give all you have.
I wish that you don't suffer, but take the pain.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Tony Rorick, and I am the interim superintendent for the Cotati-Rohnert Park Unified School District. It's my pleasure to welcome each of you to this celebration and official opening of this new gym, the Theater Academic Gymnasium Building. We call it the T.A.G Building at Rancho Cotate High School. I also want to thank our community for your support that made this facility a reality, especially those of you who worked so very hard behind the scenes to pass our 2014 and 2016 bonds. Today we have two of the individuals who were in charge of the bond committee to raise funds and to run the campaign, City Council Member Pam Stafford, and also Rohnert Park City Council Member Susan Adams. We also have with us today Joe Ploffer from Congressman Mike Thompson's office. Joe's right up here with us. I'd be remiss without thanking Karen Schubert, Christina Alva, Mindy McKeon, and Jessica Holman for their efforts in organizing today's events. Plus, thank you to all the students with the blue shirts that will be your tour guides a little bit later. I'd also like to thank the amazing IT team for their diligent efforts in helping us to utilize this facility. It's now my pleasure to introduce some of the individuals sharing the stage. First is Board of Trustees Jennifer Wildermuth. Next is our Board of Trustees President, Leffler Brown. We have with us Board of Trustees Mr. Joe Cimino. And Trustee Chris Achilles. So now that I've got you seated, I'd like you to stand and join me as we salute our flag. In this direction, please place your hand over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Emily and Nafi, would you please take the ends of the ribbon, raise it up. Principal Gansler, President Brown, please do the honors. Now it's my pleasure to introduce our Master of Ceremonies, Lexi Nelson, the Rancho Cotate High School 2019-2020 Student Body President. Lexi.
Hello, supporters of Rancho Cotate High School. My name is Alexis Nelson, and I am the Associated Student Body President for the 2019-2020 school year. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to the grand opening of the T.A.G building. On behalf of the student body of Rancho, I would like to thank you all for participating in today's opening ceremony and helping us dedicate the Henry J. Sarlot Gymnasium. We appreciate all that the communities of Cotati and Rohnert Park do for our students and staff, and we look forward to the incredible opportunities that the T.A.G building will offer to the future generations of students. I would like to call Principal Gansler to the microphone to address the audience.
Thank you. On behalf of Rancho Cotati High School, I welcome you all to the new T.A.G building and Henry J. Sarlot Memorial Gymnasium. Many people made this building possible. The Board of Education and Superintendent who envisioned it. The dedicated group who organized the political campaign to finance it. The thousands of working experts who designed and built it. And most of all, you, the community who supported it. This building is a testament to the community's commitment to provide the best for its children. During this school year, I have given many tours to students, parents, educators, and the media. And what has struck me is the sense of awe each person feels in looking at the building. Why is that? Why this feeling of respect and wonder? The building is large, to be sure. But there are many large structures in this community. The size alone does not explain it. I think, rather, this building is inspiring because of its purpose and its promise. The T.A.G building delivers on the promise of what is best about education: to awaken the creativity and talent that lies within our children, and to inspire the best in them. I think about the students who will learn to dance, sing, and perform, the students who will become stronger and faster as they hone their athleticism, and the students who will find their calling, their career, in this building. This building was expensive, but there is no better use of money than to support children. As Benjamin Franklin once said, an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. This community has invested in its children, and it will see the reward for generations. Thank you for making this commitment. It is appreciated. And I promise you, this school is grateful for what you have provided us. We will do our best to deliver on its promise. Thank you again. It's now my pleasure to introduce Amelia Torres, our student board member.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for being here today celebrating this momentous occasion. My name is Amelia Torres, and I am the school board representative from Rancho Cotati High School. I have been involved with the Associated Student Body since I was a sophomore, and I am now a senior. I would love to thank the residents of Rohnert Park and Cotati for approving the two bonds that enabled the construction of this beautiful facility. This is a necessary addition to our campus, and one that is not and will not be taken for granted. The T.A.G building has been a work in progress since I was in middle school, and I've been fortunate enough to see this project come to fruition. Now, one of the main goals of our ASB class is to instill the same sense of pride we carry for our school in the rest of our student body. This building is going to play a huge role in unifying not only our student body, but our entire community. This past year, serving as school board representative, I have come to understand how much work, effort, and time went into this building and the lasting benefits that it holds. It will increase community awareness regarding all the fantastic things that my fellow students are constantly working so hard to accomplish. We have always rightfully been recognized for our fabulous sports programs, but with the addition of this building, our drama department, dance team, computer science programs, and everything in between will have the same opportunity to excel and be recognized for their accomplishments as well. I think it is safe to say that my fellow students and I have never been more proud to be a part of this Cougar community. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Next, I would like to introduce our next speaker, Mr. Kevin McQuarrie. Mr. McQuarrie is the chairman and principal of WLC Architects. Thank you.
Well, good morning, everyone. I told Mindy I wasn't going to write anything down, but I did it anyway. So I just want to say thank you, and on behalf of the entire WLC design team, how honored we are to have been a part of seeing this vision come to reality. There's been tremendous support throughout the whole entire Cotati-Rohnert Park Unified School District to make this building happen. I'd like to introduce some of my team members that are here today that were dedicated to this over the last many thousands of hours over the last 4 years. So is Jackie Bassman, did she make it here, our project senior associate and project architect? She'd stand up. Oh, she must not have made it here, but I know that Ted St. Germain is here today, where he is. And yeah, there you go. It just takes a tremendous amount of time and effort to bring these buildings forward. When we began the master plan in 2014, there was a clear vision of improving the facilities for this district. This TAG building is the latest in the line of these successes, starting with the Thomas Page Academy, Crane Elementary School, the Lawrence Jones projects that's going on right now, and soon the new Tech High School, all of which are improving the teaching and learning opportunities for students in these new next-gen environments. This is why I became an architect. To begin with an idea and see it come to reality. So over the past 30 years, I've had the opportunity to realize this dream many times, but rarely with the creative and unique outcome as a TAG building. It was conceived as a place to bring the arts, the academics, and athletics together to anchor the high school community and the surrounding community and to propel it and the next generations of students successfully forward into the future. It truly is a remarkable building. Now, I was asked to talk a little bit about the building itself, and I'm sure that any of you that were involved in the many, many hours of meetings we have know that I get excited about this, and that I'm sure that Tony will kick me behind the podium here if I go too long, but I did want to give you some idea what's remarkable about this building. First of all, the space that you are in right now is the largest high school gymnasium in Northern California. It has, all right, yeah. There are three separate basketball, volleyball, and badminton courts in front of you. They are divided by curtains that come down with the purpose of being able to hold three simultaneous games at the same time so that you can host tournaments for the first time in the high school's history. During a varsity season and during a varsity game, the center court will be in the middle and the basketball standards will come down and you'll be able to see your score on the only ceiling-mounted, arena-style scoreboard in a high school in California. Now, I'm told that there's a little bit of bidding going on right now, but if you work fast, you can get your name on the skyboxes down there at the end of the court. That's already sold. That's already sold. Jennifer's already got a bid. We're going to arm wrestle for it. Okay. The stage that we're standing on is also very unique in that it connects directly into a very intimate but extremely advanced auditorium and theater right next to us. Now, the interesting thing about this is this is a 60-foot wide proscenium opening that opens up and can be used as a stage into a venue that is air-conditioned that can seat over 4,000 people. Think of what the opportunities are for that. This is envisioned as being a space not only for the community, but to provide students with the kind of experiences we want them to have as they move forward in their lives. And so having the opportunity to perform on a stage like this, to play in a basketball arena such as this, to have the band room that's over here, to have that kind of experience, or to be upstairs in the academic wing, have the beautiful view and have the technology, the IT, and the media resources that are there, is truly remarkable and a testament to the vision this community has to support their students and their community. And I have had so much fun working with you folks over the years, and there's so many friends and faces I see in the crowds, and I want to thank all of you for your support. It's been wonderful. I also would like to thank my significant other, Trang, who's in the audience tonight, for being here, and then also my mother and father, who for the past, tell you how old I am, 54 years, have never missed anything I've ever done, and they drove down from Montana to be here with us today. So I want to say thank you to everybody. So with that, I'd like to introduce a partner who has been part of the reconstruction of the facilities in Cotati-Rohnert Park. He and his team took the vision off the paper, and truly it's just a thick stack of paper, and figured out how to create this space around you that you're in right now. All the buildings that I mentioned, they have been the contractors on. They've done a remarkable job. He's a local boy. I'd like to bring up Mark Davis. Thank you.
Thanks, Mindy, for letting me follow Kevin. And I will say my parents are here as well, so. It wasn't part of my speech, but since you threw it in there, I had to add it. Hello, I'm Mark Davis, president and owner of Wright Contracting. We're the general contractor who built this facility, and I am a proud alumni of Rancho Cotate High School. Working with the district and building this facility at my alma mater was especially gratifying. I was born and raised in Sonoma County, attended local schools, John Reed Elementary School, Rohnert Park Junior High, and Rancho Cotate High. So taking ownership of this project was easy. After a competitive RFP and interview process back in August of 2014, we were selected as a general contractor and started working with the design team, WLC Architect, Kevin McCory and his team of Ted St. Germain and Mike Betko. Throughout the entire pre-construction process, we were led by an individual who's not here today, but deserves recognition and a lot of credit. That's former Superintendent Robert Haley. Robert made the tough decisions when they needed to be made, and he held everyone accountable. If you committed to something, you better fulfill that commitment. Robert's constant mantra was to design and construct, get the maximum use of the space and maximum use of the bond money, and I think we're successful. We finished the project on schedule and under budget. I want to thank the school board and district staff that we worked with for the past 4 years during design and then construction. Thanks to the teachers and students that tolerated the noise and activity of a major construction site. I want to have a special thanks to Josh Savage. I'm not sure if the district realizes what they have in Josh, but as a contractor that has built schools in most every district in the area, and experienced many, many different facility directors, Josh stands head and shoulders above any other. Thank you, Josh. I want to recognize my staff, Rob Weaver, project manager, Joe Grulich, who's not here, but he started off as our project manager, my son, Colton Davis, and most importantly, Don Roberts, my superintendent. Even though Don was an Annaly grad, that didn't prevent Don from working countless hours to make sure we maintained our schedule and met the needs of the school. Thank you, Don. Today we're dedicating this gymnasium to Mr. Henry Sarlot. In 1979, Mr. Sarlot was my JV football coach. 40 years later, I'm sitting in construction meetings with his son, Henry, talking about this facility that's gonna be named after his father. We are proud to be a part of that process. I'd like to introduce now Rancho Cotate student, Nafe Nafe.
Thank you, Mr. Davis. Welcome. It's my honor to be here today, standing before you on this monumental occasion, presenting this amazing building that many students, including myself, have been excited for since it was first announced to us many years ago. Since my freshman year, I'd heard about this brand new facility coming to Rancho that would house many new programs that would push Rancho into the future and set us all on a path towards greatness. I, myself, have been most excited for the new theater and the programs that would follow its construction. Including modern-day and state-of-the-art technology, this theater would rival that of Spreckles Community Center, just across the way. And I know that because I have worked there and performed there as well. Accommodating 250 audience members, an all-new sound and light system made for this space, and an incoming student body that is yearning for the high school arts program they have been told about for so many years, this addition, as well as many others, will help shape the way Rancho does things and help all of us move into the future, a better future. After serving on the Board of Trustees my sophomore year as the school board representative, I got all the information I needed to reassure the students that it was coming and that they would not be disappointed. Now, I am proud to say that the district did what it could to stay true to its promise and delivered us this new toy that many of us are excited to play with. Students and staff alike walk through these halls and rooms excited and anxious to use it as much as they will be able to, and they have much more than the district dignitaries to thank for that. On behalf of all these excited new faces, I say thank you. Thank you to the dignitaries that helped make this happen. Thank you to the realtors and architects that helped shape this facility to our community, not the other way around. Thank you to Wright Construction for completing their colossal task and creating something that will stand tall for many years to come. Thank you to the voters of Rohnert Park for voting yes on the bonds that made this possible. And most importantly, thank you to all the students and staff at Rancho who have been so patient and so helpful on this journey, who have moved around to acclimate to higher safety standards, who have lived in this community for the last year or so with no problems or complaints, who deserve this new gift and is nothing but grateful and humble for being given something so immense. Thank you and enjoy. Now it is my pleasure to reintroduce Dr. Tony Rorick, the interim superintendent.
Henry, Gail, Raymond, Sarlot, please join me here. On March 12, 2019, the Board of Trustees of the Cotati-Rohnert Park Unified School District approved this resolution naming this very room as the Henry J. Sarlot Memorial Gymnasium. Before the Board of Trustees of the Rohnert Park Unified School District, Resolution 1819-15, naming of the Rancho Cotate High School Gymnasium after Henry J. Sarlot. Whereas Henry J. Sarlot worked for the Rancho Cotate High School for 36 years, he served as the athletic administrator and taught in the business, English, and mathematics departments, and whereas Henry J. Sarlot in 1999 was named Cotati-Rohnert Park Unified School District Athletic Director Emeritus, and whereas Mr. Sarlot oversaw and guided the construction of a new weight room, football stadium, and track facilities, renovation of the gymnasium, construction of the baseball and softball diamonds, soccer and football practice fields. Many of these facilities are still in use today. And whereas Henry was proud of the 1,400 athletes that he guided to become North Coast Section CIF Scholar Athletes, and that during his career, 170 Rancho Cotate athletic teams were rewarded CIF Distinguished Scholastic Teams. And whereas he diligently worked to raise the overall student athlete GPA from
2.63 in 1984 to above 3.0 in 1998, while at the same time increasing the number of students participating in athletics from 542 to over 780. And whereas Mr. Sarlot was the pioneer of the athletics department at Rancho Cotate, his contributions still continue at the school in programs such as scholar athlete, academic awards, athletic block letters, athletic code of conduct, and extracurricular academic eligibility policies. And he dedicated his adult life to teaching and mentoring two generations of Rancho Cotate students. And Henry J. Sarlot retired in June 2003 from the Cotati-Rohnert Park Unified School District after a 36-year distinguished career. Be it further resolved that the Cotati-Rohnert Park Board of Education honors and recognizes Mr. Henry J. Sarlot for a lifetime of service to the students of Rancho Cotate and the Cotati-Rohnert Park Unified District. And now, therefore, the Board of Trustees dedicates the new gymnasium on the campus of Rancho Cotate High School by naming it the Henry J. Sarlot Gymnasium, and that a plaque will be installed in his honor. Thank you. Congratulations. But wait, there's more. Senator Bill Dodd also contacted us to congratulate the Sarlot family. The senator is unable to be here, but was able to provide the family with this certificate of recognition from the California State Senate. In recognition of the dedication of the Henry J. Sarlot Gymnasium at Rancho Cotate High School, on behalf of the California State Senate and the people of the state of California, Senator Bill Dodd. Isn't that nice? Thank you. Congratulations. Now, Henry, don't go away. It's very fitting that this gentleman standing next to me is now here at this high school. It's my pleasure to introduce Henry Sarlot, obviously Henry J.'s son, a vice principal here at Rancho Cotate High School.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Rurick, Dr. Senior, Dr. Gansler, and the Board of Trustees. Thank you for inviting me to speak on behalf of my family. On behalf of my mother, Gail Sarlot, my brother, Raymond Sarlot, my uncle, my dad's brother, Lori Sarlot, and our extended family, many of whom are in attendance today, I'd like to thank the Cotati-Rohnert Park Board of Trustees for bestowing this great honor in my dad's memory. Over 50 years ago, a young USF grad decided to forego a career in accounting and become a teacher. While some of our country's taxpayers missed out on stellar tax returns, thousands of students, teachers, parents, and coaches reaped the benefits of this decision. Henry, Hank, Dad, was an educator, coach, athletic administrator, mentor, friend. He gave this community over 38 years of service in education. He was a pioneer, as was earlier said, in the development and growth of the Rancho Cotate High School Athletic Department. He was a guiding force in the creation of baseball, softball, and soccer fields at Rancho Cotate High School. That whole area behind this magnificent building was a pasture that buffered Sonoma State. Those fields were created under the guidance of my dad. He fostered the growth of athletic participation while promoting its importance as a route to academic achievement. He dedicated his career to mentoring over two generations of students, and his contributions continue to be felt to this day. Whether you remember Dad as Papo, your coach, your teacher, the bookkeeper on your baseball team, your yearbook advisor, your colleague, or as a beloved member of your family, I think we can all agree on one thing. He was a great husband, father, grandfather, teacher, mentor, and friend. In closing, I want to thank WLC Architects, Wright Contracting, the CRP USD Maintenance Department, and the communities of Cotati and Rohnert Park for making this magnificent building come to life. It is a testament to the values we hold in our community and the vision we have for the children of this generation and those to come. I can think of no better person to symbolize this belief than Henry J. Sarlat. Thank you.
That's okay.
Did I mess up?
No, just, that's fine.
Thought of myself.
Lexi?
Thank you all for attending. I hope you will all participate in a self-guided tour around the building by these lovely leadership students that will be planted around the building to provide information. Also, please stop by and enjoy the student performance in the theater and refreshments located in the lobby. The performances will begin in 10 minutes, and please no food or drink in the gymnasium.
Thank you.